A very good morning class, 11th and class 12. We are back to the chemistry lab and we would be now testing nitrate, doing the ring test also. But the only difference in this video is that it is for those salts which have got either lead, that is group 1, or they have got barium, strontium or calcium, that is group 5 in them. Then there is a small problem that you face during the ring test of nitrate. So watch the other video of round ring test, which is for not these salts. So whenever you have a cation of group 1 or group 5, there is a trouble. I am taking lead nitrate, that is a group 1 cation. I will require concentrated sulfuric acid and will require freshly prepared ferrous sulfate solution. So as you can see, I am taking a small pinch of my salt in a test tube. To this I will be adding concentrated sulfuric acid. Now whenever you add concentrated sulfuric acid, please use a holder because it is corrosive. So I am now going to add concentrated sulfuric acid. Your focus should be the test tube. This is my concentrated sulfuric acid and I am adding it to the salt. I will add a little more. Try to observe, are there any bubbles? Have a close look. Can you see any bubbles coming out? No. Which means there is no gas evolved. Which means it does not have chloride, bromide or iodide. There is no gas evolved. At this point, you will put a piece of paper. I am just taking any piece of paper, a newspaper or anything. Just make a ball out of it and then put it in your test tube from the center. This paper piece is acting as carbon required for the reducing agent in this particular reaction. You can even use copper turnings, but a paper piece can function the same as copper turnings because it has got carbon and carbon is the reducing agent required. You need to heat the contents now and have an observation. On heating this, the salt of lead nitrate reacts with concentrated sulfuric acid and the piece of paper. Can you see the black piece of paper? This is the carbon of the paper. Now, can you see a brown gas evolved here? It is this brown gas which you have to observe. This gas is of NO2 and your salt has probably got the anion of nitrate. You can better see it on the lab coat background. The brown gas evolved and at the bottom you can see the reaction happening. Once you get this kind of a brown gas, that indicates that you have nitrate in your salt. Now, we would be doing the confirmatory test. For the confirmatory test, that is the brown ring test, you will again take a small pinch of your salt and make an original solution from it. What is the original solution? Just add water to it. Please use distilled water whenever you have lead salts, otherwise your OS will not be clear. So you will be adding distilled water to the salt and you will shake it. Shake it to dissolve. Do not proceed till the salt gets dissolved. So once you can slightly heat it if you want, just to dissolve the salt since it's very cold these days. Once your salt is dissolved, you will add 1 to 2 ml of freshly prepared ferrous sulfate solution to your test tube. Can you see? You are getting a white PPT. That's the problem. If you get a white PPT on adding ferrous sulfate, means your salt either has a lead or it has one of the cations from group 5. That is an indication. Now if you try to do the brown ring in this, it is going to be really tough. So what I advise is, please keep it for some time, wait for some time so that the precipitate of lead sulfate settles down. Now this experiment I did a while back. This is my another test tube where I have waited and this PPT has settled down like this. Now, once this PPT settles down, wait for another 2-3 minutes. Once this settles down, now you will now take the upper liquid into another test tube. Carefully take the liquid from the top and transfer it to another test tube. That is the better way of doing the test of nitrate. So, I am transferring my liquid from this test tube to this. Now I will be performing the brown ring test on this. You may discard this test tube. Now to this solution, start adding concentrated sulfuric acid carefully, slowly, and try to use a
test tube holder when you add concentrated sulfuric acid. Now this concentrated sulfuric acid is to be added from the sides of the test tube. Turn your test tube a bit and start adding concentrated sulfuric acid from the sides of the test tube without much movement, and at least 1 ml should be added. Carefully, slowly, consciously, without moving much. Now carefully straighten it up and wait for the brown ring to be appeared. It might take a small amount of time. Wait for a minute for the brown ring to be appeared and then try to observe it on a white background. Can you see a thin black line at this joint of concentrated sulfuric acid and your solution? This is called as the junction, where you get a thin brown ring. That is how a test is to be performed if you get a white PPT on adding the ferrous sulfate. Have a close look. This is the practical that I just did, and I'm showing you the brown ring of the junction at the junction. Now, if you don't do it this way and you try to do it with the PPT, it will come, but you'll have to be more patient because the PPT has to settle. Only then will you observe a brown ring like this. What I'm trying to say is, brown ring is visible whether you let the PPT settle and use it, but the brown ring is only observed in this liquid part. That was the reason I had separated the liquid part and we had done the brown ring test. So whether you do it after separating the liquid or you do it with the PPT, it does take some time. Have some patience. Whenever you have cation of group number 1 or 5, you will get a white PPT, and your target is to get a brown ring inside that solution. Whether you do it by transferring the solution or you do it in the same, but it will take a little time. You will have to wait for the PPT to settle down. Fine. So with this, we understand that the brown ring of nitrate is a tough task if you have cations of group 1 and group 5. Hope you've understood class 11th and 12th. Do well in life. Do awesomely well in life. Stay blessed, stay healthy, and keep loving chemistry. Goodbye.